Nosotros nos levantamos a las 5 de la mañana a levantar las redes. Este es mi trabajo. Y ahí sacamos los peces. Ya. Yo y mi familia soy el quinto en hacer esto.
On the northern coast of Peru lies Huanchaco, a tourist town where surfers drawn by the area's year-round waves share them with distinctive reed boats called caballitos de totora, which fishermen here have used for at least 3,500 years.
When the fisherman refers to a caballito de totora, he talks as he was talking about his wife or his daughter. He tells us that it's not only a fishing device, but it's also something that is part of the culture of this fisherman.
But the romance is wearing thin. Hard work on the boats translates to little money at fish markets, and the younger generation seek careers that fund more modern hobbies like surfing.
La cultura que viene desde muy antes y gracias a eso está las tablas de surf.
The fishermen who make their living from the caballitos not only build their own boats, but also grow the reeds they're built from.
The caballito de totora is made by one person. They have two large bundles and two smaller bundles. These two types are in a pack of 100 or 200 stems of totora, but there is one specific moment when they need help of a second person. That's the moment when they turn, they make the curve of the stern. And that's the key moment, because depending on that, you will see if this ripple will be good or bad. Here in Huanchaco and in other small communities, the fishermen grow these totora reeds in sunken gardens.
Un año para que crezca. Después lo cortamos. Al año lo cortamos la totora. Cortamos la totora, luego lo vamos a secar. Hasta que esté amarilla la totora. Y después que está amarilla la totora, se lleva y se hace el caballito.
But the sea itself is starting to threaten the construction and the culture of the caballitos.
Lo que estamos viendo es una constante pérdida por cuestiones de la erosión costera, de las filas, de las pozas que dan de cara al mar. Sin la totora, sin el caballito de totora, sin el turismo, sin la identidad huanchaquera, no somos nada. Porque nosotros somos guardianes de una cultura que viene mucho más atrás de los incas. Y somos los responsables de que esta cultura no se pierda.
Yet many say the caballitos days are numbered not because of Huanchaco's shrinking shoreline, but rather because of shifting priorities among the younger generation.
No estudiar, o sea, no trabajar en la totora, hacer pozos, tirar palana, no. Quieren surgir un poquito más, superarse.
Es otra cosa, eso es solo turismo. Yo pienso estudiar administración.
Claro. There are difficult moments for the Peruvian cultural heritage. We are losing something that is great, that is the culture of people. What makes difference this place is not the color of the water. It's not the great archaeological monument facing the ocean like Tulum in Riviera Maya, you know. What makes a difference here is the reed boat. And if we lose them, we will be another beach around the world.